Mr. President, Senator Schumer came out and said that the meeting from his point of view and Speaker Pelosi's was contentious. He also said, you said in the meeting, this is him quoting you, I just want to check, that the shutdown could go on for months or even a year or longer. Did you say that?
And I did. I did.
Is that your assessment of where we are?
That. Absolutely, I said that. I don't think it will, but I am prepared, and I think I can speak for Republicans in the House and Republicans in the Senate. They feel very strongly about having a safe country, having a border that makes sense without borders. I've said it many times. We don't have a country. I hope it doesn't go on even beyond a few more days. It really could open very quickly. I told them that bring who you want. We have three people. You can ideally bring three, but you can bring six, you can bring nine, you can bring 12. And they're going to be working over the weekend. I think it may have been somewhat contentious, but I think it was very productive. I have to say that. And I think he said that, too.
What was the productive part from your point of view, Mr. President? Did the Democrats move at all in your direction on funding of a border barrier?
Well, I don't want to get into that because I don't want to put them in a position where they have to justify anything to a lot of the people that they have to make happy. We want to save lives. We want children to be safe. The children are being decimated. And I'm not talking about necessarily children in our country. I'm talking about wonderful children that are coming up from other places, whether it's Honduras or Guatemala or El Salvador or Mexico or other places. And we have to take care of those children also. We can't let them die on the way up. What's happening to women on those caravans, you're not talking about it, but it's horrible what's happening. If they know it's not going to take place because they can't get through because we have a great border wall or fence or barrier, they're not going to come up and you're not going to have the problem. At the same time, they can apply to come into our country legally like so many people have done. And we need people, Major. We have to have people because we have all these companies coming in. We need great people, but we want them to come in on a merit basis, and they have to come in on a merit basis. They can't come in the way they've been coming in for years. I get calls from the great tech companies, and they're saying, we don't allow people at the top of their class at the best schools in the country. We don't allow them to stay in our country. So they end up going back to China and Japan and so many other countries all over the world, and we don't keep them. They get educated at our finest schools, and then we don't allow them, through a various set of circumstances, to have any guarantees of staying. So we lose out on great minds. We can't do that. We have companies that if we don't change that, and we're working on that, and we discussed that with the Democrats, and I think they agree, we're working on that. But we don't want to lose our great companies because we have a ridiculous policy that we won't accept smart people. So call it politically correct or not. But we have to let these great, brilliant companies have the smartest people in the world. Yes, ma'am. Hold it one at a time, please. Go ahead.
Mr. President, why not reopen the government to create more space to have that broader conversation?
Well, we think it could go very quickly. No, we won't be opening until it's solved. We think this is a much bigger problem. The border is a much more dangerous problem. It's a much bigger problem. It's a problem of national security. It's a problem of terrorists. You know, I talk about human traffickers. I talk about drugs. I talk about gangs. But a lot of people don't say, we have terrorists coming through the southern border because they find that's probably the easiest place to come through. They drive right in and they make a left. Not going to happen. Not going to happen. So we're not going to do that. We won't be doing pieces. We won't be doing it in drips and drabs. And I'll tell you what, I've seen a lot of people over the last week and a half. I've been right in this magnificent structure right behind you. It's called the White House. And I was here on Christmas, and I was here. My family was in Florida. I said, go to Florida. And I didn't even find it to be a lonely place. There's something very special about the White House. But I was here Christmas. I was here on New Year's Eve. And I will tell you, the people that I've spoken with, and I've gotten to meet a lot of people that I wouldn't have met, a lot of people have been coming through the White House and explaining different things and different attitudes. A lot of people that you think are upset, and certainly they're not thrilled, but they say, sir, do the right thing. We need border security. And these are people that won't be getting paid. Border Patrol yesterday was saying, sir, we're affected by it. Do what's right. It's time. This is after many, many decades. Many, many decades. This should have taken place a long time ago. We're going to get it done. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Two questions for you. Was DACA part of the discussions today? And also, why did it take this many days for a working group to come together? Why didn't you just hash the details out today?
Well, sometimes that's what happens in a negotiation. It does take longer than it should. And sometimes you agree to things that could have been agreed to 2 weeks ago. But that's just the way a negotiation is. I mean, we set out a number, $5.6 billion. We're very firm on a number. We also explained that, as you probably understand, the military is very affected. We may use the military for parts of it. Homeland Security, obviously, is very affected. We may, in addition to the 5.6, we will use Homeland Security funds. So we have things happening in addition to the 5.6, but we have to get a structure built.
Was DACA part of the discussion?
Please, go ahead.
Just to follow up.
Go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. President. To follow up on that question, with respect to the DACA program, were you discussing that in terms of a pathway to citizenship being included in the end to the partial government shutdown?
Well, we discussed it a long time ago, as you remember. That was when they had this mythical number of $25 billion. But actually, it was $25 billion, but only $1 billion up front. Then we talked $2 billion, $1.5 billion. The rest of it, the government couldn't guarantee because it's not set up to guarantee. You remember those discussions. But where it really ended was when the judge ruled against. And it was, I said, as soon as that happened, because that was a shocking decision. It was shocking to the Democrats, and it was more shocking to the Republicans. It was an incorrect decision. It was a political decision made by a judge. And I know a lot of people don't like when I say it. But try going there sometime to the Ninth Circuit and try winning a case. Not easy. Everyone files right in the Ninth Circuit. The fact is, it was a terrible decision and an incorrect decision. When that decision came down, when that judge ruled the way he ruled, I said, as soon as I heard it, I said, you know what's going to happen? We're never going to hear from them again. And that's exactly, that's what broke up the DACA deal. Yes, we had a pathway. We had many things. That was getting close to being a deal. The problem was that the money was a very small amount of money. It wasn't really the 25. It was 25 and then come back every year. Well, we don't want to go through that every year. But we were getting close, and I said as soon as that decision came down, that incorrect and horrible decision. I mean, there's been a number of them made lately. But as soon as that decision came down, I said, you'll never hear from them again. And I called up. I said, hi, it's President Trump. What's going on? They say, President Trump? We don't know who that is. It was over. The deal was over. That's what killed the DACA deal. It was nothing else. It was the judge's decision. And if the Supreme Court does what really everyone thinks from a legal standpoint it should be doing, if they don't allow the President of the United States, which is me also, because if President Obama's allowed to do that, I'm allowed to do it also. Can you imagine? If the Supreme Court overrules that wrong executive order, we'll have a deal very quickly on DACA and other things. And the Democrats want that, and so do we. But once he ruled that way, it was something you couldn't really negotiate. Yes, Haley?
Thank you, sir. Mr. President, two questions for you. Are you still proud to own this shutdown?
Well, you know, I appreciate the way you say that, but once I'm very proud of doing what I'm doing. I don't call it a shutdown. I call it doing what you have to do for the benefit and for the safety of our country. But when Nancy Pelosi said, you don't have the votes in Congress, I will tell you what I was proud of. I was never more proud of my Republican Party and those congressmen and women when they saw that and they got together and they voted 217 to 185, and it wasn't even close. That was an incredible day. I'm very proud of that, when she said you couldn't get the vote. And I'm not holding that against her, because despite the fact that I'm not saying it was an easy meeting or even a kind meeting or a nice meeting, but in the end, I think we've come a long way. And we're going to be working very hard over the weekend, and we'll see if we can do something. So you can call it whatever you want. You can call it the Schumer or the Pelosi or the Trump shutdown. Doesn't make any difference to me. just words.
Mr. President, my second question, sir, on federal workers, sir. Mr. President, my second question on federal workers, sir.
Yeah, just 1 second. Just 1 second, please, please. Go ahead.
It may be the same question. Thank you, Mr. President. Two questions just to follow up on DACA.
Yeah.
Are you open to a path to citizenship in theory for DACA recipients? And then can you explain to federal employees of the agencies that are closed, which are not Homeland Security, why those agencies should stay closed? Homeland Security is significant in of itself if it stayed closed.
Because we want to do what's right, and we want to do it all at one time. We don't want to take it in pieces. We just don't want to do that. And DACA is going to be a great subject. I look forward to discussing it. We'll discuss it at another time. But there are a lot of great things that can happen with DACA if the Democrats want to do that. I think what we're all waiting for, to be honest, is the Supreme Court justice's ruling.